Living in the Northwest, we are surrounded by an abundant treasure, nature in all its rich, diverse beauty and harmony. At the heart of this priceless endowment is a system of renewal that has flourished since the dawn of time. Life in balance. So when the salmon disappeared from Bellevue, Washington's Coal Creek, scientists searched for the reason.
One of the most exciting parts of my job as a fisheries biologist is to go out, find a problem, look at it, and come up with a solution, and then implement the system itself and see it constructed, and then come back and watch the fish return. It's so exciting to see those fish come back, and particularly watch them spawn to the point where you go out and you gather the community, you bring them in and say, look what we've done. We have fish here now.
Last November, on one of my walks, I looked down there and by gosh, there was a salmon. I was astounded. I couldn't believe it. How did it ever get there?
Years ago, when Coal Creek ceased being a viable habitat for salmon, problems were identified and addressed. The Coal Creek Community Coalition developed a plan to revitalize Coal Creek salmon, a salmon enhancement facility privately funded for the community. This comprehensive system was approved by the City of Bellevue and includes water treatment. Creating waterfalls and creek bed turbulence naturally aerates fresh water from an artesian aquifer. This oxygen-rich flow travels through a man-made branch that eventually enters Coal Creek, an essential part of restoring the ecological equilibrium. A sheltered salmon box, where fertilized eggs can hatch, protected from storm flooding that can wash them downstream before they have developed the ability to swim. And a protected rearing pond, where the alevin and fry can develop further, safe from the dangers of sediment and predation.
Being in this community for several years and working with the issues related to this, the enhancement of the Coal Creek, I've been amazed that we've worked with the city, or tried to work with the City of Bellevue for several years, and in fact, they were the ones that suggested we gather the support from other communities that are upstream to support our efforts as well to enhance the Coal Creek Basin for salmon. That's what prompted us to start the Coal Creek Community Coalition.
Providing enhancements to remedy current unacceptable conditions required close cooperation between concerned civic and resident groups.
The community has already enhanced the stream by bringing in big tree roots and salmon-friendly areas in the stream itself to help them keep them away from predators and keep them away from the stream flow.
The community's dedication has already had a positive impact on the situation. The tide has turned, but there is still more to do.
This is a report from the Stream and Water Quality Monitoring from King County, and in it it says that while the sediment ponds are helping to control excessive delta formation through reduction of large particles, smaller particles and fine silts and clays remain suspended and washed downstream. Thus, the ponds provide no protection for spawning and rearing habitat. I think that's very significant and really gets at the heart of what the community has tried to establish down here in the Delta area. We have salmon egg boxes and rearing ponds that will provide protection from that fine silt in a way that can't be done through the use of egg tubes or other attempts at in-stream egg placement or enhancement efforts.
While the City of Bellevue temporarily blocked the use of the salmon egg box, the coalition has continued using salmon egg trays directly in the unprotected stream of Coal Creek. Experts agree that in-stream egg trays are an inferior method of introducing and protecting salmon eggs when compared to the shelter provided by the Urbaniak egg box.
This box I designed, it's an effective way of raising salmon. It's actually more effective than the boxes that I put in the stream because it's able to get away from the flood events that a stream has that destroy the salmon. So from here, the salmon are able to become alevin, smolt, and then come out and exit into the stream and become young, spend their life cycle here until they're ready to go out to salt water.
The most critical part of salmon coming back to this watershed is it's returning nutrients from the ocean back to this system. And we're finding as researchers now that that's the element that's been missing for a number of years. Bringing those ocean elements in the body and in the decaying portion that stays in the creek back to this system, when you don't have that, you have a system that's not functioning properly.
I went back and I looked down, and by gosh, there were two salmon. And they were not, neither one was the first one I had seen a week before, because I could identify that. And then I heard from an email that someone had said that they thought that 20 salmon were in the creek.
The incredibly important part of this project is the fact that we have a total system. It's an ecosystem. And not only do we have salmon returning back to the creek, but we have all of the critters that come with them. You have the river otters, you have the eagles, you have the osprey, those other critters that are a part of this entire ecosystem.
But I was looking at the water, and all of a sudden a head emerged. And it wasn't a river otter, which is kind of a small head. I thought, geez, could it's a seal? No, it couldn't be a seal. And eventually it crawled up onto the bank alongside of another similar animal, two beavers. So we're getting a kind of a natural situation developing on this creek. It was exciting to see this. In all of those years that I've been here, I had not seen fish nor any appreciable wildlife. And here I was seeing it for the first time.
To ensure salmon survival, a delicate balance of personal commitment and government support is needed to guarantee a gentle yet comprehensive response. The natural interactions of all the creatures returning to this ecosystem has been observed and noted by the Audubon Society. So more than merely protecting the salmon population, the coalition has helped restore the natural order to this wilderness. It can now survive to become our legacy of respect for the treasure of nature around us.
So ideally, I'd like to see this community and the city of Bellevue cooperate to restore Coal Creek, to restore the habitat, to enhance the salmon returns. I think we should be able to work together.
So it looks like the community is improving itself. We're seeing wildlife, we're seeing fish, and we're seeing activities that, in my view, are causing this to happen. There's a development at the mouth of Coal Creek, which seems to me to be a very, very important progressive step in improving the community and improving our lives, actually. The generations down the road, I think, would thank us for doing that.
We have a proven system to ensure restoration. The fish egg box and other compensations are effective, but this project needs time to fully regain what we have lost. To this end, the neighbors of Coal Creek implore the city of Bellevue for permission to continue their efforts. Together, we look to the future. Generations of people protecting the creek, and generations of salmon returning to it.